to my channel. I've been kind of hinting at this video for a little while now, but it's been so gloomy here that I haven't been able to film, and it's still pretty gloomy today, but I'm hoping that the lighting situation works out okay anyways. This is my Foxy Fix number 3 cookie, sugar cookie, and it's the A6 size. This is the same one that I used in my last can video, but I do have a new one that I'm also going to show at the end of this video. We'll talk more about that later, but this is set up using the May Planner Society kit, which is super cute, very perfect for summer. I'm also really excited about the upcoming kit. This kind of the picnic theme with some pretty yellow and like a periwinkle blue. I'm kind of considering getting a yellow traveler's notebook to go with that one. Haven't quite made up my mind yet, but anyways, let's get into the setup of this current one. So we've got the cute bow here with a little dangly heart on the front, and then on the side I have the rose gold heart and this cute little bee charm. Let me get that a little bit closer. From Whimsy Delight. I love it, it's so cute. And then let's open her up. So first of all, I have this cute little die cut with the monthly dates on it from Sparkly Paper Co. with the little bunny. She's so cute. I just have her right there in the front pocket. And then I just have one of the extra pocket cards that came in the kit. There's a little clear pocket right here in front. Just one of these backer things. Just I kind of like to put something right here to give the front cover a little bit more weight and structure. And then I just took one of the backer cards from the kit and used it to make a washi tape kind of insert card. So I have the washi tape with me when I'm on the go. All right, in the front I have the cute girl acetate, and I just put one of the post-it notes of the same girl on the front. And then I have the really pretty pink floral paper for my weekly. And I made it into a little folder so I can stick some stickers there in the front. And then it has the cactuses on the other side. And then I have my Annie Plans week on 4 pages insert. So there's the monthly page. And then you've got like just some place where you can write some goals there. And then all of my plans for June so far. So, if you've been following me on Instagram, you know that this week I'm trying out a monochromatic theme, and I am really, really loving it. I've also gotten into trying out stamps a little bit more, which is super cute. I mean, I just love how they come out on the page. So I'll be utilizing those a lot more in future. I'm still a pretty big noob with them, but hoping to get a little more practice in. And these are the stickers that came in this Planner Society kit. I haven't used, well, I think I used one of them on one of my dashboards. We'll get to that later, but that's all I've used because they're so cute and they're so kit specific. It's hard for me to use them because you know, you only get one, and once you use it, it's gone. Which is kind of the case for a lot of sticker kits that I own from other shops that are have very exclusive, you know, we sell this for a couple weeks and then it's gone forever. And it's hard for me to use those because I'm like, ugh, what am I going to do when it's gone? I love it. So you got the back side there, the pretty floral again, and then the other side of the acetate. And then this was supposed to be centered, but the glue, like, I don't know. The glue just shifted over during time. I don't know how that happens. But this is one of the cute little shaker cards, and it says you do you, and then I've got my monthly tab here, and I just put some washi down, and this is the blue palm tree paper, and on the other side it's got the cute just kind of green splotches. And then I used the flamingo washi tape, and some of, not all of the washi tape came in this kit. I do subscribe to the washi subscription portion, so I believe this one, I believe these two came in the, this one and this one came in the regular kit, and then this one and this one came in the extra washi subscription. just to clarify. All right, so then I have my monthly calendar, which I haven't filled out too much for July because I'm going to be out of town for quite a while. But I'm starting to get some stuff, some future plans in there, which is nice to have a future planner. This is a little TN insert kit from my shop. Have in there because I'm planning on using that next week. And then there's the back side of that, and I just decorated that a little bit. I took one of the bags and just glued it in there, so now I have a little pocket on the back, which is nice. And I am planning on putting some stickers in there because I'm going to take this with me on my vacation next month. So I'm going to try and put everything that I need in this traveler's notebook for planning, and hopefully it will last me. I won't need anything extra. So then I have this, and I printed out this adorable new weekly traveler's notebook insert from Annie Plants Printables, and it was a collab, I believe, with Simply Watercolor Co., and it's just so cute. I haven't used it yet, but I intend to use it in the near future. And then in the middle of that, I just stuck a little dotted notes book for like some of my little doodles, ideas, practice, color, swatches, practicing some of my hand lettering, that kind of stuff. And then there's the back of that, yeah, Simply Watercolor Co. And then this is just a Foxy Fix dashboard that I stuck one of the papers in, and then I've stuck a little die cut in there. And then the next dashboard, I really love how this one turned out. It's got the palm fronds and the black splotches, I guess that's what you'd call them, because they're not really dots, they're like, yeah, like paint splotches. And then one of the puffy sticker, actually two of the puffy stickers, and the cute girl die cut, and then yeah, there's the one sticker that I use, hashtag planner girl. And this is my meal plan dashboard. This is another printable from Annie Plans. I used the floral washi on the back side there. And then this is just my meal plans. It's really great. I love how I can write down everything we're eating that week on the left, and then a grocery list on the right. Sorry I'm saying so much. Struggle with that. I don't necessarily eat what I write down specifically on that day. It's mostly just a list of what meals we have to choose from. And then depending on what we feel like or how the day goes, then we'll pick something off of that list. And in the back here, I have attached another one of the pocket cards with the clear pocket. And I stuck in the little cute little planner girl stamp, which I'm going to be utilizing soon. I've practiced with it a little bit just in my sketchbook, but I haven't actually used it in my planner yet, but I intend to do that soon. Sorry, I flipped forward too far. So there's the back of that. I just left it plain. Now this really pretty vellum. Oh my gosh, I love this vellum so much. It feels so pretty. I've never really understood. There are some people out there that will laminate their vellum, and I understand they want to preserve the pattern and have it not get destroyed, you know, in their planner when they're flipping it and they could rip it or whatever, but the feel of vellum is like part of what makes vellum so special. I love having it in my planner. I hope that Christy includes more vellum in future kits because she doesn't always include it, and I just think there's something special about it just brings that planner experience to the next level. Anyways, behind that I have the green splotchy paper because I thought it just kind of gave the vellum on top a nice effect. And then I have a tab that says Girl Boss because this is my Etsy notebook, I guess, where I write down like ideas for future stuff that I want to do, things like that. And then I have my Georgia Peach Traveler's Notebook insert. This is one where I, like it was a misprint, I printed on the wrong side, so I just stuck it in my planner and I'm going to use it in the future. Not quite sure when yet because I'm going to use that other one first. So that's that. And this is just in a pattern that's in one of my kits, and I know it doesn't match the rest of the planner, but I still like it. And then we have the palm trees and the blue, the back of that, and then the vellum. And then over here we have the flamingo acetate. I've never used acetate before and I like it. It's kind of got the same feel as vellum, not by touch, but just like this kind of that similar look where it's got a pretty pattern, but you can see through it. But yeah, it definitely feels plasticky. But it's cute, and I put some die cuts on top of there in the corner. And then I have the girl washi behind this, and the cactus paper says Planner Society Girl, and then one of the shaker cards that came in the kit that says You've Got This Sweet Girl. And then this says My List, and then there's the back, that pretty floral paper, which is the cutest paper, in my opinion. And then this is covered with some paper from a bag from the April Planner Society kit, and it's just lists. Like, that's all it is, it's lists. I have a quote in here, list, movies that I wanna see, some washi swatches, just for anything random that I wanna jot down, kind of like a brain dump page. And then that's the back, and I put the other cute girl die cuts and cactuses, the girl washi, and then the back of the acetate. And then I have the sticky notes in here, the cute pen, and just some larger stickers of some stuff that I carry in my shop. And that's it for the sugar cookie. Now, what I wanted to show you is I actually was able to get two traveler's notebook setups out of this kit, which I found to be pretty exciting. So you can get more out of it than one traveler's notebook. Obviously, it does depend a lot on the sizes that you're using, because if you're using a really large traveler's notebook, then no, you're probably not going to get a second setup out of it. But let me show you. I have this traveler's notebook that I'm kind of experimenting with. It's a passport size. It's a lot smaller than I'm used to, but it is cute, and it's a lot easier for carrying around, like in your purse. So I'm thinking about getting an insert for it and using it as a wallet. It has this cute silver heart on the spine. It's a wide, and it has this really adorable pen. And this is a collab with Pen Gems and My Newest Addiction, and it is so pretty. I love it. And it goes really pretty with this black. I believe this is the licorice. So I just have another die cut from Sparkly Paper Co. I thought the penguin obviously fit in perfectly with the black. I've got these cute little frilly boxes from Miscellany Boulevard. And then I've got a couple dashboards. So I've got another Planner Society die cut here. She included three in the kit. And then I used a piece of one of the bags as the background washi, some puffy stickers. And so this is my calendar. So I have this mini, just monthly calendar in here. And then this one I decorated with some more die cuts, some washi, the paper again. And then I have this really cute weekly insert, which is another collab by Annie Plans Printables that she did with Fox and Pip. It's really cute. It's got her signature little bow clips and cute girl carrying her planner. And I thought this would just be really good because sometimes I need to just write down what's going to be going on next week before I actually sit down and plan. So I thought this would be really good for that. So I can't wait to get started using that. And then there's the back of the dashboard, and then I got to use the beautiful vellum again, and I used the same splotch, lime green splotch paper behind it. But I put some extra elements on, like I used a backer card and some puppy stickers and a few more die cuts. And then I just have an insert that I print out from Annie Plans Printable, and I just designed my own cover for it because the cover was a little bit too bright, so I designed just a simple black and white floral cover and stuck it on there and covered up the front and the back of that. I really like how that turned out. I might do that more often now and create my own sticker covers to match the theme of my whole planner. So then we've got the vellum behind that. And then I use this other vellum that I didn't use in the other one. This is the palm tree vellum. And then I took one of the bags and I made it into a little folder just to hold some really lightweight stickers. And then another bag that I can use as like a pocket to stick stuff in right here. And then the back of the vellum. And then I have this cute little koala because she matches the pen that I'm using in this traveler's notebook, so I thought she would look cute right there. And I'm still playing around with this. I don't have it set up 100% how it will probably end up in the end, but I just wanted to show you that I was able to get two traveler's notebook setups out of one Planner Society kit. So that's it. Those are my two flip throughs. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope this helped maybe inspire you to create your own planner setup, or maybe made you feel a little bit better about your setup because it looks better than mine. I wouldn't be surprised if that's the case. But thank you for watching. I really appreciate your beautiful comments and seeing all the views and the likes. So if you liked this or found it entertaining or useful or helpful, please like and subscribe. And I hope you're having a great week. I hope you're having a great summer, and happy planning.